Good morning students, welcome to our channel Math Study. Yesterday we have seen certain questions on trigonometric ratios. Today we are going to begin new topic, which is trigonometric ratios of some particular angles. So let's begin. Let us consider one right angled triangle. Let A, B, C. Let triangle ABC be a right angled triangle. Now, as we know, the sum of all angles of a triangle is always 180. So, this is 90. It means that sum of these two acute angles must be 90. So, the combination may be like this. 90, 70, 20. See, 90, 70, 20 degrees, all numbers are in degrees. It may be 90, 60, 30, 90, 45, 45, maybe 90, 40, 50, and so on. So, these may be the combination of angles for a right angled triangle. Okay, but in our study, we have to see the trigonometric ratios of only some particular angles. For example, we have to see the sine, cos, tan, cosec, sec values of 0 degree. Now I will explain you how the 0 degree angle is 0, 30, 45, then 60, and then 90. We have to study the trigonometric ratios of these particular angles only. Okay. Now, we will see how to do that. Here, we'll take a table, sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, secant, and cotangent. Sine, cos, tan, cosec, sec, cot. In this way, we have taken the names of six ratios. Now, we'll take some columns, 0 degree, 30, 45, 60, and then 90, in this way. In this way we have drawn a table. Now, sine 0. First of all, you have to see what is the zero angle. See, this type of structure, normally we call it as an angle. If it is less than 90, then suppose this is 90. We know it less than 90, acute angle, right angle, greater than 90, obtuse angle. Okay, some people call it obtuse. So in this way it happens. Now, if the angle does not rotate, this is the first arm, two arms are there. If the first arm and this second arm coincides each other, it means that if the angle has no rotation, then such an angle is called a zero angle. Okay, now see, we draw a right angle triangle. In right angle triangle A, B, C, let us take an angle of measure 30. It is 90, it means obviously it will be 60. Now, in the last year, we have seen a theorem, 30-60-90 degree theorem. What theorem says? Theorem says that if your hypotenuse is a centimeter, whatever it is, if your hypotenuse is a, then the side opposite to 60, then side opposite to 60 is root 3 by 2 times the hypotenuse. So it will be root 3 by 2 times A. And side opposite to 30 is half of the hypotenuse. This is 30 and side opposite to 30 is BC. It will be half of the hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is A. So half of A is just like this. Half of A in this way. Now, sine 0 is 0. Angle does not rotate. Sine 0 is 0. I will explain you how it comes. Sine 30 means 30. Opposite upon hypotenuse. Half A upon A. A get cancelled. How? Sine 45. Now, 45 angle does not come here. We will leave it. Okay? We will do it afterwards. Sine 60. What is sine 60? Opposite AB upon hypotenuse AC. Root 3 by 2 A is its opposite upon hypotenuse is A. A get cancelled. So sine 60 is root 3 by 2. Then sine 90. Now whatever the angle is, it may be 90, but what is sine? Sine is opposite upon hypotenuse. Now if you see here, this is a 90 degree angle. Its opposite is AC and hypotenuse is already AC. So AC upon AC, A by A is 1. That's why sine 90 is 1. Now, as we have taken a 30, 60, 90 degree triangle, 45 degree angle does not come in this triangle. So we have to draw a separate triangle for that. Now, see, 90 degree, it is 45, so obviously the other will also be 45, 45 plus 45 plus 90, it will give you 180. So, again name it ABC, sine 45. Now, you will slightly get confused, sine 45. But which 45 should you take? This or that? But before explaining you sine 45, let us go a year back where we have studied an isosceles triangle theorem. Or we have also seen a 45-45-90 degree triangle theorem. I don't know whether it is present in CBSE or not, but yes, it was present in State Board. What does the theorem says? Theorem says that if your hypotenuse is A, then the angle then in a 45-45-90 degree triangle, side opposite to 45 is 1 by root 2 times hypotenuse. Is 1 by root 2 times hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is A. So 1 by root 2 times A means 1 by root 2 A. Side opposite to 45. But here 45 angles are 2. So this is also side opposite to 45. This is also side opposite to 45. So it is also 1 by root 2 times A. Now you have to find sine 45. To find sine 45, as the angles are same, they are identical, you can take any one of the two. I will take this opposite BC. We are taking sine 45. Opposite BC upon hypotenuse AC. BC by AC, 1 by root 2A upon A, AA get cancelled. You will get 1 by root 2. Similarly, by using this triangle and the previous triangle which we have rough, by using those two triangles, you can find the remaining ratios. Every time cos will be. One thing is remain. How this 0 comes? Sine 0, 0. And if you take cos 0, it will be 1. How these values come? See, as I told you earlier. If the angle does not rotate, if the angle rotates in this way, then you will draw a perpendicular and it will be a right angle triangle. Then you will take theta, then you will say opposite upon hypotenuse. These all things will happen when the angle will go from this point to that point. But if the angle does not rotate, so you are not going to get this opposite side. Opposite side will not be present. So as there is no opposite side and sine is opposite upon hypotenuse and there is no opposite side, so whenever we take sine 90, you are taking sine 0, because this angle will be 0 then. If this arm will not rotate, it will overlap the same arm and 0 will not be there. Zero will be there, the angle zero will be there. So as the opposite side is not present, sine zero is zero. But when the things come to cos, what is cos? Cos is adjacent upon hypotenuse. Now see, these are the fictional things. You cannot see those things physically. You have to imagine these things. Now suppose that this is the opposite and suppose this is theta. I will name it A, B and C. If we have to take cos theta, how we are going to take cos theta? This adjacent AB upon hypotenuse AC. Okay. Now, if the arm or this much angle is not present, this angle will be zero. Then what will happen? This initial arm and this final arm will be on the same time. This is an angle. And if the angle does not rotate, it means both are same. So the adjacent AB and it will overlap AB and hypotenuse AC will be same. So AB and AC will be same. Same things gives you one. So in this way, you are going to get cos 0, 1 and sine 0, 0. Because in case of clear definition, clear explanation is, in case of zero angle, you do not get the opposite side as it is included in sine theta opposite upon hypotenuse. That's why sine 0 is 0. In case of cos theta, you get the adjacent and hypotenuse same. So same upon same is 1. That's why cos 0 is 1. Okay. Now remaining angles are same. You have to take those two triangles and every time you have to measure adjacent upon hypotenuse, you will get them. For tan theta, you have to find opposite upon adjacent, okay. But for the students to remember them this chart in the exam, we have some simple tricks. Many times I taught this trick in the class also. Every year, SSC going students, we explain this kind of tricks. What you have to do is simply, once you got the sine row, once you got, just reverse that row and fill your cos row. One. You have ended, begin with 0. Here you have to end with 0. 45 will be same in every case. Root 3 by 2 will come here and 1 by 2 will go there. You can verify these values by drawing the triangles. Okay, for example, draw 30, 60, 90 degree triangle and let us check whether cos 30 is root 3 by 2 or not, whether cos 60 is 1 by 2 or not. In this way, you can verify that. Okay. So now tan theta is nothing but sine theta upon cos theta, means every time divide the sine value by cos value and you will get tan value. How? Let us take an example. To get, we have three thetas, theta, theta, theta. Put 30, 30, 30. So how you are going to get tan 30? Just by dividing sine 30 by cos 30. Now what is sine 30? Sine 30 is 1 by 2. What is cos 30? Cos 30 is root 3 by 2. 2 to get cancelled. What remains? 1 by root 3. So you got 1 by root 3. In this way, divide every sine value by every cos value and you will get the tan value. How? 0 by 1? 0. 1 by root 2 divided by 1 by root 2? 1. Root 3 by 2 upon 1 by upon 1 by 2. 2 to get cancelled. Root 3 by 1. Root 3 by 1 means root 3. 1 by 0? Not defined. 0 by 1 may be 0, but 1 by 0, it is not defined. You cannot define that. Okay. Now, once you get tan, just reverse it and get cot. Okay. For example, in tan column, in tan row, you ended with not defined. Begin your cot with not defined. 0, 0. 45 values are always the same. Okay. You got that. Then, for tan it is root 3, for cot it is value of tan 60 is equal to value of cot 30. In this way, 1 by root 3, here it comes, 1 by root 3. Okay, now cosecant sec left, see, in case of cosecant sec, see, to get cosec, what is cosec? Cosec theta is nothing but 1 by sine theta. 1 by. 1 by means take reciprocal of sine values and you are going to get cosec values. Reciprocal means we have to reverse them. Ulta karna padega. How? See. Now this is 0. 0 means 0 by 1. If you reverse it, it will be 1 by 0. And we know 1 by 0 is not defined. So cosec 0 is not defined. Okay, then 1 by 2, reverse it, 2 by 1. 2 by 1 means 2. 1 by root 2 will be root 2 by 1. Root 2 by 1 means root 2. Root 3 by 2, its reverse will be 2 by root 3. 1, 1 by 1, 1 by 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. It will be 1. Okay, now to get sec, you have to do one thing. You will get sec either by reversing cos. You can reverse, take the reciprocal of cos values and you will get sec values. Or just write down this table reverse. For example, 1, take 1. 2 by root 3, take 2 by root 3. Root 2, root 2. 2, 2. ND, you got ND, not defined. In this way, we have completed a table which you have to learn how to fill. Okay, just don't do that parrot reading, parrot learning, upat punch. No, take it seriously and see how the values came. Because when we solve the questions, we are not going to remember every time. It is not possible to draw the whole table. We need either one or two values. Okay, we are going to take the problems in the further videos, but right now we got this. Okay, so here I think we should stop now. In this way, we have completed our trigonometric ratios of particular angles. We have taken some particular angles. 0, 30, 45, 60, 90. Now, after 0, we have directly taken 30. This does not mean that there is no value of 25. Yes, sine 25 is there. Sine 21 is there. Sine, each and every number has the sine ratio. For example, you may take the sine value of 21.1. Okay. But in SSC level, 10th standard level, you don't have that much amount of mathematics. You have to learn it in 11th, 12th or maybe in BSc levels. Okay. So here we will stop now. Okay. So subscribe our channel, as well as you have to share this video with your friends also. Okay. This is our lockdown project. And I think as many as students should take the benefit of this. Okay. So up till now, we'll stop here. Thank you.